On June 5th, 2022, at 10:37 a.m. local time, the Bulusan Volcano in the Philippines produced an unexpected explosive eruption. This eruption originated from a vent on the volcano's summit, producing a dark gray plume of ash which rose upwards to a height of 2,743 meters, or 9,000 feet. Pyroclastic flows subsequently raced across the slopes near Bulusan's summit, traveling several hundred meters before coming to a stop. Minor eruptive activity then continued for several more minutes, continuing to eject large quantities of ash into the air. By 10:54 a.m., the 17-minute-long eruptive episode had ended, by which time the majority of ash had drifted to the west and northwest. Ash continued to fall over the next 30 minutes, depositing about half a centimeter of material in some locations 5 to 7 kilometers from Bulusan's summit. What had just occurred was a completely unexpected volcanic eruption from Bulusan which did not eject any lava. Rather, its eruption was essentially a powerful hydrothermal explosion, which in this case is called a phreatic eruption. Phreatic eruptions are a very common type of volcanic eruption which either occur during the early stages of a larger magmatic eruption, or as is most likely the case with Bulusan's eruption, represents an isolated event. They are caused by the interaction of underlying magma which lies underneath the volcano with regional groundwater. This magma generates large quantities of heat which is transferred upwards and outwards to surrounding rock. Some of this rock subsequently heats ever-present groundwater, generating on occasion hot springs on the surface. However, if groundwater is heated at an exceptionally fast rate or it has no natural outlet, then this water may flash to steam. Since steam takes up a greater space than the same volume of liquid water, this causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, the pressure becomes too great and the ground explodes upwards in a new volcanic eruption. Much of the fine ash particles represent rock pulverized by the explosion rather than lava, despite the two types of eruptions having a highly similar appearance. Phreatic eruptions are thus one of the hardest volcanic eruptions to predict, as they can occur at any volcano with an active hydrothermal system and magma with little or no warning, as was the case with Bulusan. Before it erupted, Bulusan was at the lowest alert level on the 0 to 5 scale, which correlates to the color code of green. However, due to the dominantly phreatic nature of this volcano's eruptions, a permanent exclusion zone was kept in place. This exclusion zone prevented casualties from occurring in today's eruption. 5Volks has since raised the alert level at Bulusan from 0 to 1 and reminded citizens not to travel within the 4-kilometer radius exclusion zone of the volcano for any reason. Additionally, people in a second area which extends to 6 kilometers away from the volcano as labeled here should be at a heightened state of vigilance and be prepared to evacuate with little or no warning. This zone represents a sector of the volcano where destructive lahars and pyroclastic flows are most likely to travel. Speaking of lahars, some small-scale events might occur during the next several heavy rainfalls. These lahars will be slightly acidic and thus you should not cross regional low-lying riverbeds and drainage channels. Additionally, the fresh ashfall has likely made large swaths of the regional drinking water unsafe to drink for the time being due to contamination with toxic metals such as fluorine. Instead, drink bottled water for the time being. Until the ash has largely dissipated, please wear a facial covering, preferably an N95 mask, to protect yourself from exposure to small ash particulates, which can damage your lungs. It is unknown whether more phreatic explosions will occur, as eruptions at Bulusan often occur via several widely spaced events over a several week to month period. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Peter Lawler for supporting this channel.